Chavi, so can you name
okay.
a female condition where you will see there is one extra chromosome other than one normal X chromosome? There may be many X chromosomes. What do you call that condition?
Polyploidy. Triple X chromosome.
Super female, beta.
Achha, okay.
That condition is super female. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So that is then. What are the sinuses of pericardium, beta? I told you during the embryo development, heart is
transverse and oblique sinus.
Yeah, heart is invaginating inside the pericardium because of which two folds are created on the posterior aspect, no? So that's what we have, transverse and oblique sinuses. Very good. So here the question is, what are the of transverse sinuses of pericardium? See, this one is transverse sinus, beta, and this is oblique sinus. So transverse sinus, what are these two structures you are finding? The pulmonary trunk and the ascending aorta. Lower down, you are finding this N-shaped or H-shaped is veins. Superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and four set of pulmonary veins we have. Okay, so that is. See here, oblique sinus is the question. Narrow gap behind the heart, like it. Anteriorly, it is bounded by left atrium and posteriorly by parietal pericardium and esophagus. On the right and left side, it is bounded by reflections of pericardium, as is shown here. Better, these are the reflections of pericardium. Okay, so next question is, this also unlimited times I have discussed right coronary artery. Right coronary artery is coming from where, beta? Tell me the cores, everything. Now it should be on the tip of your tongue. Ritika?
Ascending aorta.
Yeah, very good, Megan. Ascending aorta. Okay, then can you tell me the cores from the anterior aortic sinus? You will see this is the right coronary artery, which is running between the right auricle and the pulmonary trunk at its point of origin. Then it is descending downwards, forwards, and laterally on the right side. Okay, and then it is coming behind. Okay, it is binding and coming behind, and it is finally terminating into the posterior interventricular groove, continuing as posterior interventricular artery. Now let us see the various branches. The first branch it gives is, the very first branch it is giving to pacemaker of heart, that is SA node, isn't it? Then, because it is right coronary artery, obviously maximum branches are given to the right side of the heart, that is right atrium. Okay, part of right ventricle and a part of left ventricle is supplied. The other branches named ones are along the margin, that is the lower border of the heart, inferior border, you are finding marginal artery. Further course, when it is going behind, you are finding it is continuing as posterior ventricular artery, and it is forming an anastomosis with the left coronary artery. Okay, so that is all about right coronary artery. So that finishes our question paper. So we will stop here, beta, then.